Before we start, warning. Spoilers ahead. So today, I'm gonna explain a mind-blowing science fiction movie from Thailand called Deep. The movie starts by showing a man with a medical suit who is trying to jump from the top of the school building. Scene continues to classroom where Professor Nitsha, teacher and also principal of the school, explain about insomnia. She tells her students that insomnia is a physical disorder caused by stress and anxieties, and will bring worse effects if you keep staying awake for longer time, such as perception of reality becomes distorted, hallucination, etc. This is Jane. And she is the main character in the movie. She is used to going without sleep. The medical student spends her night studying, caring for her grandmother, and worrying about her little sister June. She's obsessively concerned with the safety of her house and checking the lock multiple times only to make the nights longer. This is June, Jane's sister. June usually comes home late because of practicing music and her sister accuses her for sleeping around. June is unhappy with that statement and they start fighting. June's phone falls off and the screen is broken. June then walks away and leaves her sister alone. When Jane discovers that they are extremely behind on their home loan, she comes to the school principal and tells her that she wants to drop out. Otherwise, Professor Nitsche suggests Jane to sign up for a German pharmaceutical project offering huge cash compensation. The project is called Deep, which is dedicated to harvest a chemical from a brain called cretonin that essentially can be used to wake up coma patients. The project itself consists of 3 levels and the duration of each level varies from each person. The higher the level, the more cretonin that will be extracted. Out of nowhere, suddenly a man called Dr. Hans Miller approaches Jane. He is the director of research in the company. He offers Jane to participate in level 1 and she will be awarded $3,000 upon completion. What Jane really needs to do is implant a microchip in the occipital area and stay awake until a certain amount of cretonin is extracted from her. Because Jane is so desperate to help her family, she finally agrees to the offer. Hans also handed a watch to measure the amount of cretonin harvested and to alert the user if he or she falls asleep. If the user falls asleep for more than 60 seconds, they will die because of short circuit which will stop the heart. Jane soon discovers 3 more of her classmates are also part of the experiment. It's Win, a top-class party animal who spends more time in the club than classroom. There's also Sin, famous beauty blogger, and Peach, a gaming nerd who always follows Sin wherever she goes. The students become quite the foursome and support each other through in order to get easy money from the Deep project. They finally got 100% in their watch which indicates that their first level has been completed and get the chip extracted from their body. Easy money given from the professor and they immediately spend their money on entertainment and stuff. Jane gives her sister a brand new phone and Sin decides to spend the money for a boob job. You know what I mean. While playing bowling, Sin tells her friends that she has been followed and stalked by someone lately and suspects that it's from the German company. Suddenly Jane changed the topic and asked her friend whether they want to participate in the next level of Deep project, and all of them spontaneously says yes because of the easy money. The day after, they gather again at German company's lab and ready for Deep level 2. This time, they'll be required to produce more cretonin, so it will be about 5 days with no sleep at all. They hesitate a bit at first, but when they find out that they will be paid $15,000, they suddenly accept the offer. After 3 days without sleep, the indicator from the watch shows only 40% of cretonin has been harvested. On the other hand, they begin to feel the side effects of staying awake. Win starts to hear strange things, hallucinating, and suddenly punches his friend for no reason while playing basketball. Jane also becomes emotionally unstable and easily irritated. June asks her sister what happened and how she could be able to gather that huge amount of money. Unhappy with the questions, they get into conflict and Jane walks out from her room. At this moment, June spots the German pharmaceutical business card and figures out what Jane has been doing. The next day, the insomniac group meet at the canteen and complain that the cretonin percentages keep stucking low. At this moment, Jane spots that Win has a higher cretonin percentage than the rest of the group and realizes that keep moving will increase the percentage faster. They decide to conduct a night party at Peach's house. They are having fun and Win figures out a brilliant idea to keep them awake, which is mixing stimulant pills with mocktails. At first Jane hesitates to drink because the pills may cause strokes. Win assures them that they need to make it through the night and finally the rest of the group drink the mixture. They continue to dance and surprisingly, Jane starts to dance like a madman in front of her friends. At this moment, the cretonin percentage rises sharply and Win has already harvested 83%. After getting out from the toilet, Sin accidentally goes into Peach's room and figures out that Peach is the one who has been stalking her all the time. Sin is very shocked and suddenly faints. The situation turns into chaos. They need to wake her up while the time in the watch keeps ticking. Luckily because all of them are medical students, they manage to wake Win up in the last seconds and at this point, they finally manage to harvest 100% cretonin. The next day, they come back to the company and state that they will not proceed to level 3. The doctor keeps persuading them to continue because nobody's done it better than them. The doctor also offers enormous amounts of money, which is $30,000 to the kids, but a no is a no. They reject the offer and walk out from the room. Life goes on as they decide not to go back to Deep. Since that stressful moment, Sin is not willing to talk to Peach again, even though Peach confesses that he likes Sin and all of the stalking happens because he cares about her. Then we jump to a scene where Win asks Jane to come with him to the Ed Sheeran concert. But Jane rejects the offer and says that she has no time for doing such a thing like that. Jane then continues to walk home when she suddenly sees a corpse wearing Deep Project's watch on his wrist with 0 seconds on the screen. In the middle of the night, Jane's grandma suddenly suffers stroke and has to be taken to the ICU. Jane meets June and says that they couldn't afford the hospital fee and have to move their grandma into another hospital. Unexpectedly, June pulls out a brown paper bag and asks whether that amount of money would cover the fee. Jane figures out that June has also been participating in Deep Project and is very angry about it. And once again, they have a fight and June states that she also wants to help grandma. Filled by anger, Jane desperately comes back to the company only to find out that her sister has just implanted a microchip to her body by Dr. Hans Miller. Jane asks the doctor to remove the chip off or she will call the police, but the doctor threatens Jane back by not going to take off the chip if Jane and her friend won't proceed to level 3. She takes her sister and walks away from the lab. She meets her Insomniac friends and begs for help. But majority of the group, except Win, refuse to participate in Deep Level 3 because it's a suicide and then leave them. Before sleep, Sin and Peach flashbacks their memories when they were having fun with each other, and feeling guilty about it. The next day, Jane with her sister and Win go back to the lab and find that Peach is already waiting for them. Surprisingly, Sin also comes and the group continue to meet Dr. Miller for Deep Level 3. To help the group get through the final phase of Deep Project, Professor Nietzsche gives Exerol every day to keep them awake and provide an old lab for them to stay. The principal also says that they can call her anytime if they need help. Each day goes fine until they reach day 6 of the experiment, where the group start hallucinating again. Suddenly Sin screams in the toilet, breaks glass, and scratches his face with glass. Sin goes into madness and blames Jane and her sister that her face looks like shit because of them. The atmosphere starts to heat up and they begin to fight one another. Win attacks Peach and says that one wants to be friends with a sick loser like him and because of that, Win got a punch in his face. Given the current condition, Jane starts to panic and runs to find the principal. Jane finds a room and when entering the room, Jane is very shocked finding out that all this time they have been monitored by the professor. Jane also figures out that Dr. Hans Miller is just a role and not an actual doctor. Jane returns to her friends and commands his friends to call the police immediately because Professor Nietzsche is the mastermind of Deep Project. But they can't reach the signal and when they are trying to escape, they have been locked from outside. The principal calls from the intercom and says that she will extract the chip after 100% Kretonin harvested or after they died. Finally, they have reached day 7. Aware of being watched, Sin destroys all the CCTV and Win suddenly faints. Realizing that one of the students is unconscious, Professor Nietzsche comes to the room and manages to bring Win to his room. Suddenly someone hits the professor from behind and she falls down. Unexpectedly, it is Win who comes back from death. The group gathers in the professor room and explains that they used CCL that could cause cardiac arrest and fake a death. Professor Nietzsche explains that the man that jumped at the beginning of the movie was Jed, her lover 24 years ago. Jed was able to survive, but in order to escape from the coma, Jed needs to be injected with certain amounts of Kretonin. That's why Professor Nietzsche initiated the Deep Project in order to extract Kretonin from sleep-deprived human brain. Feeling cornered, Professor Nietzsche manages to grab a syringe and injects drug into Jane and she suddenly collapses. When Sin and Peach try to hold the principal back, Win and June try to wake Jane up. Time has already passed 60 seconds but Jane still does not show any response at all. This left them in a state of hopeless despair. When June's crying and hits his sister's chest, it suddenly wakes Jane up. After that, Professor Nietzsche is arrested and none of them getting paid for joining Level 3. At the end, everyone has chosen to sleep like a rock, rather than to sleep like the dead and never to wake up and see the sun again. Subscribe to watch more videos like this, turn on notifications and leave a like to help the channel out. Thank you for watching.